Hi, I'm Andrea, and this is part 4 of my video, Windows 8 with the Metro theme disabled. And as you saw in the previous video, you can run Windows 8 with the Metro theme disabled, and it's just a simple registry edit that disables the Metro theme on Windows 8, and it brings back the Windows 7 and Windows Vista start menu. And also, you can install a software called Classic Shell, which puts the classic Windows 98 and Windows XP start menu with the expanding programs menu back onto Windows 8, as it does on Windows 7. Classic Shell you can use on Windows 7 and Windows Vista to bring back the Windows XP and Windows 98 start menu. And Classic Shell also works on Windows 8 and will give you a Windows XP start menu on Windows 8 as well as a Windows 98 start menu. And so you've got the normal, so when you disable the Metro theme, you've got the normal start menu on Windows 8, you only get Aereo theme or Windows 8 Basic. On Windows 7, there was Windows Classic, which is, you know, the grey taskbar and the inky blue desktop, which is the Windows 98 Windows Classic theme that is included in Windows 7, Windows Vista, and Windows XP, which gives you a Windows 2000, Windows 98 look and feel, and you can change the grey taskbar to any colour you want. You can change the blue desktop to any colour you want. But unfortunately, Windows Classic is not included in Windows 8 and is sadly missed by me and other Windows users who were using Windows Classic, because I like Windows Classic because it disables the Aereo theme completely on Windows 7 and Windows Vista, and it would on Windows 8, but there's no Windows Classic on Windows 8, so you've only got the Windows 7 Basic start menu on Windows 8 and the Windows 7 Aereo theme on Windows 8, but it's a start menu. Do you know what I mean? It's a start menu. And anyway, in this video, I'm going to show you more on Windows 8 with the Metro theme disabled. I'm using Windows 8 as my main operating system on one of my netbooks, and the Metro theme is permanently disabled. I don't use the Metro theme at all. Metro theme on my Windows 8 is permanently disabled. I don't use it at all, and I find that if you disable the Metro theme, Windows 8 actually runs better and faster with the Metro theme disabled. And I would advise any Windows user who is thinking of switching to Windows 8 to disable the Metro theme completely, because unless you are interested in running the Metro apps or you like the Metro apps, which I don't, then really the Metro theme is pretty much useless. So it's better to disable the Metro theme on Windows 8 and have the Windows 7 start menu on Windows 8. So it's better to disable the Metro theme on Windows 8 and have the normal start menu on Windows 8. Here, I'll show you more of Windows 8. We'll close the sidebar so we can see better. The normal Windows 7 control panel. It's the same as Windows 7, it is no different. And I'll show you some themes now. I think we should personalization. This is what Windows 8 looks like with the Aereo theme. I call it Windows 7 Aereo, but it's Windows 8 Aereo, because we're on Windows 8 now. We're not on Windows 7 anymore. And there we are. That's Windows 8 with Aero theme. That's a transparent Aero theme. I don't like the Aero theme, and I don't like the Windows 8 Basic. I like Windows Classic, but they've removed it from Windows 8. There might be a registry hack or something to bring it back, but I'm not going to bother. But you can also change the desktop wallpaper and change the desktop. Change the desktop background. Go to Pictures Library, where I'm going to select one of my pictures. There you are. That looks like Windows Vista, doesn't it? Look, with the Aero theme, Windows 8 looks like Windows Vista. And how about if we add the sidebar for finishing touches? You would never know this was Windows 8 just by looking at it. You just couldn't tell, you know? Looks exactly like Windows 7, but of course it's not. And what if you want to use the classic start menu? The Windows XP, I like the Windows XP start menu on Windows 7, and I like it on Windows 8. There you are. There is my Windows XP start menu on Windows 8. And this is classic shell. And it puts the classic start menu back into Windows 7 and Windows 8. And there's other theme support. There's this theme, which is a new theme we didn't have before on Windows 7. This is new. We didn't have this on Windows 7. It says extended theme. Don't know what they mean by that, but... And we'll close the Windows XP start menu now, so I can show you more of the themes with the Windows 7 start menu on Windows 8. So you can run this exactly like you did Windows 7. Windows 8 is almost exactly the same as Windows 7. There are some differences, but I don't actually see them. See, we've got... other themes here. I don't want high contrast white and black, but for some reason they've gotten rid of Windows Classic. Don't know why. This is Windows Basic, Windows 7 Basic theme, Windows 8 Basic theme. And you can change the window colour, I think, on this. So it's like the Windows 7 Aero, change the taskbar colour. But for some reason, when you're on Windows 8 Basic, the start menu is white. You can't change the colour of the start menu. It's just a white start menu on Windows 8 Basic. It only changes when you're on Aero theme. But maybe you don't like this kind of Windows 7 background. I don't really. So you've got choices here to change the desktop background and make it a solid colour, which is what I'm going to do. Solid colour. That's a solid colour now. Dark pink, so I can make the desktop background a solid colour. There's my Vista sidebar over there, the Windows sidebar. And all the most of the Windows Vista apps work on Windows 8, as I explained before, and so do most of the Windows XP apps and software work on Windows 8, as well as the Windows 7 software. The only software that doesn't work on Windows 8 is Windows Mail and AIM Messenger. They're the only two I've tried that doesn't work. There you are. And we also have Aero Theme. I'll put it on Aero Theme. And I'm going to put it back on my original theme now, the blue theme. Well, I mean, you can make the desktop background a solid colour, which helps partly disable the transparency, but you've still got the Aero taskbar and start menu. You can't disable Windows 8 Aero completely on Windows 8. I mean, on Windows 7 you've got Windows Classic with the start button and that looking like Windows 98, but you can't do that here. But on Windows 8 it's different, but all of the applications here work on Windows 8. Windows Explorer, the ribbon's disabled, and Windows Explorer is the same as Windows 7's Explorer now, and I've put the Classic Shell toolbar in Windows Explorer. And all my applications are working. It helps to install Classic Shell on Windows 8, because if you want to use it with the Metro theme, as I said before, you probably need the start menu as well. You get Classic Shell from here. And this is Classic Shell, this is the software I've got, this is the website where I downloaded it from. And it does support Windows 8. Classic Shell works, it's for Windows 7, but it works on Windows 8. This is where I downloaded it from. And so all the apps work on Windows 8, so that's really it. And going to shut down now. So Windows 8 does work. In the beginning I thought that Windows 8, because of the Metro theme, would be the operating system that nobody could use, because everybody said that it didn't have a start menu, and all the videos and the websites that I read about Windows 8, I couldn't really find anything positive at all about Windows 8. But when I tried Windows 8 Developers Preview for myself, I found out that I could use Windows 8. You've seen Windows 8 running in the Metro theme. Although the Metro apps don't work unless you have a really, really high screen resolution, but I think they don't work anyway, because I think Microsoft have disabled them, because it's only a developer's preview, so that's not I think they've been deactivated or they're not working as yet. But all the apps that show up on the Metro apps menu that you've installed as software, like Firefox, Google Chrome, and Ace Explorer, Windows Media Player, if you click on those apps, of course they will work, because they're the software that you have installed, and also the Control Panel app works and the Windows Explorer app works. But I would advise Windows users who are using Windows 8 to disable the Metro theme, because it's easier to manage with a start menu than what it is to manage without the start menu, but it's really personal choice. I'm running Windows 8 as my main operating system at the moment, because I've installed Windows 8 on my netbook, and It used to have Windows 7 on it, but now it runs Windows 8. And I've disabled the Metro theme completely. And if you don't want to do this through the registry, you can download Metro Controller or another software like that that will disable the Metro theme for you. And so you can disable the Metro theme on Windows 8 and have a Windows 7 start menu on Windows 8. And, you know, apart from the Metro theme, Windows 8 is exactly like Windows 7. Well, almost, except it's a bit slower than Windows 7, of course. And some of the software that you was running on Windows 7 would not work on Windows 8. Windows Mail doesn't work on Windows 8, as I said, and AIM Messenger won't work on Windows 8. And you can't run Internet Explorer 8 on Windows 8, or even Internet Explorer 9 on Windows 8. You can only run Internet Explorer 10, but when you use another browser like Avant Browser or Advanced Browser, which is an Internet Explorer-based web browser, that runs in the Internet Explorer 8 code. So I think it still has some of the source code in Internet Explorer-based web browsers. They still have some of the Internet Explorer 8 source code, or I think Windows 8's got the Windows 7 source code and the Windows XP source code, otherwise I wouldn't be able to run any of my Windows Vista software or Windows XP or Windows 7 software on Windows 8, but I am. So most of the software, 95% of the software that you're running on Windows Vista and Windows XP and Windows 7 will run on Windows 8. Not all of the software will run on Windows 8, but most of it will. Most of it, but not all of it, I want to say. And you can downgrade Windows Media Player. The default Windows Media Player that comes with Windows 8 is Windows Media Player 12, but you can downgrade that to Windows Media Player 11. And as I was showing you, I'm running Windows Media Player 11 on Windows 8. And Windows 8 Developers Preview is due to expire on the 11th of March, but they are bringing out a beta version sometime in February. That's what I read on the web. So I hope to be able to upgrade to Windows 8 Beta, or Windows 8 Consumer Preview, as it's called, sometime in February when they bring it out. And I've taken precautions. Because it's a netbook with no CD drive, I bought one of these. It's an HP CD drive that I can boot from a CD. And I've also got my, I've got my full installation Windows 7 CD. So if I have any problems installing Windows 8 Beta or Windows 8 Consumer Preview, I can always roll back to Windows 7. Because once you install, I installed Windows 8 on Virtual Clone Drive by downloading the Windows 8 ISO file and mounting it on a Virtual Clone Drive. But once you install Windows 8, it does a clean install and it wipes out your Windows 7 or Windows Vista or whatever you have on your computer before completely. And so therefore you must have one of these, a CD drive, and if you've got a netbook like I have, it's a USB plug socket, and you plug the USB into your into your CD drive, and the other end into your netbook or laptop, and you know, and you can boot from a CD with this or back up your files on a CD. Just have a look at it. Or DVD, and I've taken precautions. I've bought a Windows 7 Home Premium CD, so if I cannot install Windows 8 Beta for any reason, or I cannot install, if I cannot upgrade to Windows 8 Consumer Preview, I can always put Windows 7 back on my computer that I installed Windows 8 on, and that's very important. Keep your Windows CD handy in case you have to, for any reason, roll back. Because something could go wrong with the installation. I'm not saying it would, but it could. But just in case, you can always roll back to this. Or Windows XP or Windows Vista if you have your CD for Windows Vista and Windows XP. So I hope to upgrade to the Windows 8 beta version, and of course when I get the Windows 8 consumer preview, I'm naturally going to disable the Metro theme. I've got no intention whatsoever of using Windows 8 with the Metro theme enabled, because I don't like the Metro theme. I must have a start menu, and also I've installed a classic shell which gives me a Windows XP and a classic Windows 98 start menu on Windows 8. So I've got the Windows 7 start menu on Windows 8, I've got my Windows XP start menu on Windows 8, I've even got my Windows XP wallpapers on Windows 8, and my Windows Vista sidebar, and all my Windows Vista and Windows XP software, including all of the Movie Makers 2.1 for Windows XP, Windows Movie Maker 6 for Windows Vista, and Windows Calendar for Windows Vista, and Windows Live Essentials and Windows Live Messenger for Windows XP all work on Windows 8. So you can run Windows 8 the same way you can Windows 7, because Windows 7 is very flexible. You can run all of your Windows XP software and Windows Vista software, and you can do the same on Windows 8. So Windows 8 has proved to be the operating system that you can use, not the operating system that you can't, and I'm very pleased about that. So if the time should come in the future when the shops stop selling Windows 7 and we're forced to buy Windows 8, at least we'll know that we can use it, and at least we'll know we'll be able to have a normal Windows 7 start menu on Windows 8 and not have to use the Metro theme. I'm Andrea, and this is my video. I hope you enjoyed watching. Bye.